She actually did something that I never seen in this company when I joined. In 2002, I think it was. She organized an event in Chennai. All right? And there were almost 20,000 crazy dreamers in that event. You know, Chief was there, Dato Sri was there, some of the directors were there. And I myself, I only saw this kind of crowd in football games or hockey games. But seeing 20,000 people attending to a speakers forum, networking event, it just blew my mind away. To say that, wow, this is possible? Well, this person did it. She was a single parent when she got started. She has two beautiful sons. And she worked so hard. And I saw her in action when I went to Chennai. And there were times when she comes to Malaysia. And she does events in Malaysia. And I used to attend those events. And I was like, wow. She is truly a dreamer. She is truly a warrior.
And right? Despite facing a lot of challenge, what mesmerized me is that with all these challenges, when she found QNET, she is able to decide and make a decision to build QNET, not just for her, but for the next generation.
And it's not only next generation, Lina. She has managed to build for the next 7 generations probably. All right, that's how hard she works. All right, you are very privileged to be able to hear from her today. She'll be sharing her journey, what she has achieved, how she got started, and it will just blow your mind away.
She is also the testimony for being a big dreamer, a powerful lady from Chennai.
So guys, please help us welcome V Padma.
Padma!
Namaste. Hope everybody is enjoying the week on. I wish all of you are really learning from each and every speaker. I wish you are 100% focused in these 3 days. Don't have any other works. Just be attentive in this week on. Make sure all your partners and especially your family members are attending the week on. It's very important that our family members know what we are doing. Don't miss even one speaker also. And it reminds me about my first week on, which was in 2001 in Goa. I attended with 20 of my teammates. And we learned so much. We came back and we applied, we practiced. And it has helped us. Every learning we took from the week on has helped us to move further without any hurdles. And every speaker has put something into our mind, you know, that has given us some hope. It has increased our belief system. It gave us a lot of confidence in moving forward. And I was nobody when I started this business. When I started this, I was nothing. I was full of problems. And this business has helped me a lot in moving forward. And it has brought me from nowhere to somebody. I was nothing when I started. I was full of problems. And thanks to Dato Sri Vijayeshwaran and thanks to the Japadas Bismarck, who are the founders of this company and who have changed so many people's life all over the world, and I'm one among them. And I feel so blessed. I feel that the purpose of my life is this. If my story, my journey can inspire few people's life anywhere in the world, I think that I am done, I am blessed. So let me share my story, how I started. I started my journey in 2001. This business has been brought to me by one of our family friends. Of course, thanks to him for all the pressure he has given me in making me to understand this business. When he gave me this business, I was into deep financial crisis and I had a broken marriage. I was married at a very early age, at the age of 16. And by the age of 24, I had two kids and I already ended up with a divorce. And I had to work, I was self-employed. I started a traditional business, borrowing money outside to survive. And the biggest challenge of my life that time was, I gave birth to my eldest son, Chetan, who was bilateral amputee. He was born without his legs under the knees. I was just 18 years and I didn't know what to do, you know. I didn't know what's happening to my life. I didn't know what to do with that kid. And I just moved forward. I was never stuck. I thought I have to do something with this kid. I have to do something to the kid. I'm the mother end of the day. And moving forward, I gave birth to another child. By 24 years, it was Yashwant. So everywhere it was dark. I was surrounded with a lot of problems around. And my mother was not having a happy life back end at my native place. She was not treated well by the daughter-in-laws. And she was suffering at that point of time. So I could not even go to my mother's place for rescue. I could not take my sad story to my brothers also. I decided to face all alone in my life. I traveled, I had a traditional business, borrowed money, started the businesses. Entered with so many businesses everywhere it was. Ended up with losses. But finally, I had started a textile showroom, a boutique, and a beauty parlor. And that, it started working out, you know. Working out means, already in the family, we had lot of debts. By the time I went to divorce, because of the family's commitments or whatever the family members have done, because of that, I ended up with 60 lakhs of Indian rupees loans. You know, like, you know, that amount is, to tell this now, it looks like one figure. But there were so many financials in that 60 lakhs of loans. And where everybody used to give so much of pressure, you know. I had sleepless nights. For years together, we had sleepless nights. Giving food for the children, paying the rents, running the businesses. And I was young to handle so much of pressure. And like God sent person, somebody has come into my life, bringing this business into my life. Good. I really thank God for giving me that sense of urgency for me to take up this business seriously. And in 2001, I think I started this journey. I traveled. Initially, I could not take it seriously. But again, thanks to the person who brought me into the business, had made me to understand the importance of this business, how important it is for me to take up the business seriously. Like many of you, I had a lot of excuses. You know, because I have to run the family, I have to make money. You know, if the food, the school, the rental, everything has to be run by one person. You know, but again, thanks to that person who told me that you want to just survive in the same thing, you want to stay where you are. If you're doing the same thing and again, you'll end up with the same problems. He made me understand that I have to do something differently. And he told me that, you see, you have already made something, you have put something into the business. So why didn't you take this seriously? So thanks to that person who made me to understand, opened up my ideas, you know, opened up my brain to think about the new ideas. Anyway, I was fed up of all the problems which was happening in my life. I felt that enough is enough. I cannot run away from these problems. I decided to face the problems. I don't know, from one of my mentors' trainings or somewhere, I felt that I need to face the problem. So I started visiting all the financiers who lent money to me and told them, please give me peace of mind to make money and return it to you. I went to each and every financier. I went personally to them, started telling everybody, saying that whatever you do, like, you cannot even pull out one penny from me. But give me time. I'm into a new business and I'm very confident that I can make money there and I can definitely return to you. And even though they did not agree, I did not leave their offices until they had given me time, at least for 1 or 2 years. I said, I have nothing else to do, so you have no choice than giving me the time. I went to the school. I have requested the school to give me time to pay the school fees. I went to the landlord, took the time to pay the rentals. I had to make little money for the food, that's all. So wherever I had the financial problems, I went and faced it. I came out of my fears. And I started taking the business very seriously. You know, till that time, what was happening was, it's like, you know, we charge our phones 100%. But suddenly, with no time, the charge drops to 30, 40% or 50%. Because there are a lot of other apps which was taking up this charge. So when we remove these unwanted apps, what happens? The charge remains the same. Same way, I have removed these pressures, other pressures from my mind and started focusing into the business. That was an excellent strategy which has made me so successful. Keeping all these things in the head, we cannot focus. Such a big business, we need focus. One point focus is very much important. Consistency is very important. Without getting deviated into other problems, focusing on one thing is very important. Just business, 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 presentation activities, presentation activities. This was very important where my upline and gurus were telling me that focus. So after I took a decision not to focus on the problem anymore, that's where my business started giving profits. So that's what I tell most of my people. If you're having excuses, where are you giving the excuses? To whom are you giving the excuses? Because end of the day, whatever we are doing is for our success. Remember, guys, whatever problem you have, whatever obstacles you have, hurdles you have, challenge you have, crisis, name anything. Name anything. Your frustrations, name anything. The only solution is our business. You are a love failure. You have a broken marriage. You are not able to manage anything at home. For anything, the only solution is success in our business is the only solution. But I understood this. It took me 1 year, maximum 1 year, to understand that. And I started focusing, total 100% focus. And thanks to the Mauna sessions, in early stages, we have learned Mauna from Dattoshri Vijayeshwaran. And in every Mauna, every day Mauna, I used to tell myself, Padma, you are capable. You can face anything. You can overcome any challenge. You are born to win. This is what I used to tell myself every day. That has really helped me to remain positive always. I started hitting every obstacles. There was so much on the path. Journey was not easy. Journey was tough. But my goal was to reach the destination, which is make my kids financially free. Give them proper food, give them a home, give them vehicles, make Chetan somebody, get good education to Ishwant, and do something for myself. Have some good bank balance. These were my goals in my life. The minute I stopped giving excuses to myself, the minute I started facing everything, every problem in my life, everything started working out. It was only focus, just give my 100% every day. It happened was everything, whatever was disturbing in the path has become my path. Every obstacle came to me to make me stronger. When I started facing every obstacle, I started getting stronger and stronger. And I understood that every obstacle which came in my way was only creating a future for me. I understood that every path was leading me to another success point. After going there, I faced something else. But when I face it, when I move forward, it was leading me to a different level of success. In this 22 years, guys, in this 22 years, multiples of challenges I would have faced. But I'm telling you, if I have to give the one big credit to something, I would say thanks to all the problems or challenges or obstacles which came in my way. If I failed to face them, I think I would have gone to my traditional shop, sit there, my loans would have gone up like anything, and all the financials would have taken my peace of mind one fine day. I don't know what would have happened to me and my children. You can imagine. So that was focus on the business without any excuses had really helped me. You know, from where to where my life has changed after that. It took me maybe 2 years to clear all my loans. I went to each and every financial's office. I had paid every person with interest. Where I got back the entire respect which was lost. I settled them with the interest what I committed in the initial stages when I took the loans. And the best part was I brought my mother and I kept her with me. She never had a happy life in her life. She struggled so much to bring up her kids. I was the only daughter. She was not happy with my marriage life. She used to be so unhappy with what was happening to her daughter's life. I brought my mother, kept her with me, and trust me, guys, I gave a fantastic life to my mother. And whatever she was expecting in my life, I could show her that. She was so proud. One fine day, she was so proud. And she always wanted me to live in her own house. And just before she passed away in 2005. And I could buy a palace-like house. And I showed this house to my mother. I still remember the happiness she had in her face when she saw her daughter in her own house. And the best reward I got from this business is the transformation of my eldest son Chetan's life. As I already told you, I didn't know what to do with him. I didn't know what can happen in the future. I didn't know how this child can walk. But one thing I always believed in, the miracles. Miracles do happen. We need to believe that miracles do happen. We need to only work and move towards what is supposed to be done. Without having any doubt whether things will work out or not, we have to move forward. That's what I did. I just started giving my best. And God made it happen. My son Chetan had become an international car racer. The money what we made in this business was useful so much towards his imported prosthetics, which could support him in his car racing. We could spend a lot in improving his skills, in giving the best training to him. And Chetan, with his talent and with his hard work, had become an international car racer. What else to be proud, guys? What else to be proud? I'm so proud of him. Today, everybody knows, all over the world, when it comes to car racing, everybody knows who is Chetan. He is Chetan, the international car racer. He makes me feel so proud of him. And my youngest son, Yashwant, who was extremely good at academics. Thanks to this business, where I could give him the best education, and he had done his chartered accountancy. And he is getting ready to start his own company. From nowhere to somewhere, guys, look at our lives. It is the hard work, the effort, the belief, which we never gave up at all. I never gave up at any point of time. Faced lot of challenges. Generally what people do, you know, there will be challenges, but keep on crying and talking about the problems. What is the use? You're stuck. Just talking about the problems, you're stuck. Are you moving forward or moving backward? Some people give a lot of effort for so much of time. If something comes on the way, just stuck. Give up and move on. But this business belongs to people who never give up, who just believe, who feel proud and start believing this company, believing in our founders, believe in the leadership of our founders and move on. I did so, and all my V partners or all the successful people believed in the leadership of this company. Yes, there might be a lot of companies around who come and vanish just like that. A bad company will run away when there are challenges. A good company will survive, but a greatest company will improve and keep moving on. And we belong to the best company of this industry. QNET is the best. My dear all, don't ever lose your focus on unwanted stuff. There'll be a lot of things happening around us. And we are into the business, and any business will have its own challenges or issues or problems. It's not necessary that we need to react to every problem which is happening. Every problem has got its own solution. It will be solved. Why should we lose our focus? We should reassure our goals, and we have to keep moving towards our goals. So we have the company, we have got our mentors who are looking into everything what is happening around us. So let us be focused and stick on to our duties, what we are supposed to do. And now, I just want to read it to you. The best learning I got from my mentor, Tatoshri. This is something which is very close to my heart. This is something I practice. This is something I keep reading every day. This is something when I feel that I need a motivation. This is something I read when I miss my mentor. This is my journey. Whatever I'm going to read in this is what is necessary to follow throughout my journey. People are often unreasonable, illogical, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people will accuse you of selfish or ulterior motive. Be kind anyway. If you are successful, you win some false friends and even true enemies. Succeed anyway. If you are honest and frank, people may cheat you. Be honest anyway. My favorite line. What you spend years building, someone could destroy overnight. Build it anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, people may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today, people would forget tomorrow. Be good anyway. Give the world the best you have, and it will never be enough. Give the world the best you got anyway. You see, in the final analysis, it is never between you and them. It is always between you and God. That's what, guys. These are the lessons I learned and practiced in this 22 years. This big success have come from adjusting and accommodating according to the people. Dattoshri made us understand that people are different. They're not wrong. Everybody is different. I am different and they are different. And we have to adopt people as they are. Nobody will change for us. We have to change for the people. So learning this, I have changed myself according to the way they want me to be. And I understood that nobody is going to change for me. And the changes have helped me. My changes for people has helped me to hold the people and to build the teams. And in the process, we would have given our 100%, we would have done sacrifices and so much in building them, in making them earn, to take them in a different level. Maybe they might forget that. They may not be grateful. We should never expect a gratitude from them. We should never expect people should remember the support or a help you would have done to them. Just you have to move on. This expectation that people should be thankful to you or grateful to you can be another big problem in your life. Not accepting people as they are may be another problem in your journey. You would have taken so many years to build your business. Maybe it might collapse overnight because of someone. It's okay. We can build it again. In these 22 years, I can tell you how many times the system, my business would have collapsed for various reasons, not one reason. Maybe because of me or because of my people or because of a lot of other things. But I never stopped building it. Like Datto said, build it anyway. I kept on building it again and again and again and again. And my reward was huge. So guys, we will face several problems in the process. It's okay, as long as you never give up. You remember, you can deal anything and you are born to win. Believe in the miracles. Just give your 100%. Do your duty. Don't waste your time in any negativity. Just reassure your goals again and keep moving. The company is with you. Our founders are with you. Chief is with you. The V partners are with you. The directors are with you. Your leaders are with you. And you belong to the best industry on this planet. Just believe it, that this is your last ship in your life. Thank you very much. God bless you. Namaste.
Thank you, V Partner Padma. Your story is truly inspirational, all right? And I like what you said. When you believe, miracles do happen. Lina?
Thank you, VP Partner Padma, for sharing such an inspiring story once again. I believe when you share this story, you just touch so many women's life out there. And women's out there with a big dream, by listening to what VP Padma share, I believe any woman can outshine any man in the world. Are you listening to this, all the women out there?
I totally agree with you, Lina. I totally agree with you.